Hello. Good evening. Thanks for having me here. My name is Artem Filatov, and actually I'm an artist. I'm not, I don't know, a professional curator. I usually do some projects and work with programs and some kind of events in order to succeed in maybe more complicated and more structural aims and ideas and focuses. So right now I'm not going to speak about what I do as an artist and what I accomplish as an artist, but what I'm trying to do as a part of a crew of people who are working in Nizhny Novgorod and trying to develop some kind of an issue about some problems with preserving cultural heritage. So first of all, I'm going to speak about what is Nizhny Novgorod actually. Nizhny Novgorod is a large Russian city with population about 1.5 million people. And it is a very developing city with historical center, with lots of wooden architecture from 19th century. This architectural heritage is one of the highlights of the city and one of the biggest nowadays problems. When we are speaking about wooden and cultural heritage, we understand that history and preserving of history is a very difficult and important point in when the city is getting some money, getting some investors, getting some developers, and at some point it is impossible to stop, for example, those buildings not to be demolished at all. So one of the key moments in the history of historical heritage defense is when a group of activists blocked the machinery from destroying a fully reconstructed building that was bought by a local developer in 2013. This case became an agenda for a couple of months, but because activists stopped the construction works. But in the end, this building was demolished anyway. If the previous house was sold because of the administrative pressure to the owners, some people tried to stand against the big developers. As a result, in 2010, lots of wooden houses where people refused to sell their property were put on fire. Arsons burned the houses down and even took lives of many people who didn't expect sudden flames. This picture on the left is showing a building which is now demolished, where people were burned alive. The picture on the right shows us a question sentence from a neighbors of a burned house, how to live further. And the good thing is these houses were safe and still remain on the same place. Sometimes people successfully defend their property. The owner of this house with a Belvedere is, sometimes people successfully defend their property. For example, this is the house which was owned by Lydia Davidova-Pichorkina. She fought for it in a court against local municipality because the land under her house was sold to a developer. With hard work, making a small exhibition space with a museum about the history of this house, she won the court. She defended her right to stay in this house, but later in 2013, she died in the age of 76 years, and her bequest was not to sell her house at any matter. But after her death, her relatives sold it to the developer, and in 2015, it was demolished. Sorry for some mistakes. There are positive examples of historical buildings restoration, but frequently businessmen who own those buildings have no interest in investing. This one-of-a-kind Art Nouveau building is a historical heritage monument and is preserved by the government, and it is now in private hands, and it still stands without any usage for years. In 2015, one of those buildings, one of the building's walls started falling down, and the owner was forced to work on a project of reconstruction, but up to now it remains unimplemented. This neo-Russian style wooden building was on the edge to be lost, but in 2015, one of the Nizhny Novgorod activists who is defending the cultural heritage joined a public talk with President Putin and addressed him the problem of preserving this exact house. So Nizhny Novgorod municipality was forced to find a solution and invest about 12 million rubles into restoration. It sounds really great, yes? But eventually this rather small amount of money, for restoring, for repairing a wooden house eventually, a restoration company without needed experience, bad building conditions provoked a significant harm to the house. All those actions were implemented without even knowing for sure the final goal, who will keep the building and what for it is going to be repaired. First works on wooden buildings by made by local street artists appeared first in 2011. Firstly, it was rather safe spot for illegal activity, as lots of wooden houses were burned or abandoned. Later in 2012 and 2013, artists started working with inhabited houses, people who live with habitant houses. People who live there appeared to be more open-minded, easily agreeing on giving walls for paintings and even helping the artists by storing their paints on night and feeding them while they work. By 2016, the center of Nizhny Novgorod covered about 180 works, mostly of them were made illegally by street artists, except for about 40 works were gone. For example, the red dots are the remaining works that remain till this moment, and the gray works, the gray dots means that some of these pieces were demolished or stolen or something like that. Loyalty of the people who live in wooden houses towards young artists influenced a very unique approach that local artists possessed. Instead of conflict, they were ready for a dialogue. Instead of bright and catchy images, they were choosing more adaptive and more appropriate style for public space paintings. Artists were not afraid to talk to people first before starting to work, and they were free to work all day and all night without no hurry, and the murals were enhanced with stories and history told by just local inhabitants. In 2014, we decided to expand this local artistic experience by making a street art festival program. The key idea of the program was the call for submissions from citizens of Nizhny Novgorod who are willing to participate with their houses. This is one of a kind principle for Russian street art festivals, as most of the time people are absent from the process when administration and some curators deciding where to paint and what exactly to paint. We instead decided to continue maintaining horizontal relationships with people and artists in a new, more project-like manner. And as a first try, we invited three artists. One of them is a Moscow-based artist, Alexei Luka, who replied to a submission from a woman who lived in this wooden house and who was very anxious about making it better. This experience and existing cities' problems led us to an idea of making a festival purely dedicated to historical heritage and active people who try to preserve their old houses. In 2015, we called for submissions from inhabitants of historical houses, asked them to share their stories to understand the whole picture better. The idea was to make a dialogue between artists and active people in order to make a site-specific work, prepared especially for this house. By these actions, we wanted to change the mass media approach by bringing into the light the fact that not all wooden houses are in bad conditions, and not all people are hoping to leave them as soon as possible. But there are people who stand and defend their right to live in their houses that is connected with their ancestors. This is a house painted by Stas Dobry from Moscow and Timofey Radia from Ekaterinburg during the festival New City Asian in 2015. People who live there are a rare type of Russian intelligentsia, being far relatives to a famous Decembrist, Iosif Poggio. Their house was under attack when a developer started building a big block of flats nearby. They survived three arsons, but defended their house anyway. The artists decided to paint all sides of the building with lacy napkins and quoted the autobiography of Saint Augustine, who made his confessions about memory and how we remember and forget things. This is a mural painted by Nizhny Novgorod artist Andrei Alenev in 2015 during the festival. This house is situated in the district where people were calling for abidance of the law. The developer who built a block of houses was obliged to support local neighbors from wooden houses with new accommodation, but he refused to do it in time. So the people had to call for attention and even painted their house with slogans. One of the walls of the building was chosen for work, and Andrei tried to keep the original sentence that just said, "Dear Mayor, it is much better here. We have no roof, let's change our cottages." This work was made by two Nizhny Novgorod artists. One is Andrei Druzhaev, and another one is Vova Chernyshev. On a house which is situated nearby a house of a famous Soviet engineer constructor Rostislav Alexeyev. Faina Lipson and her husband were the only inhabitants who refused to sell their flat to a developer. The artists wanted to reproduce the feeling of a garden that was planted by the previous residents, that even has plants from the red list. Eventually, after long and difficult time of defending the property, the following aggression from the developer forced Faina to agree on term of a new flat. It was a hard time when the developer taken away the windows from the flat on the second floor, so we helped Faina to cover them to prevent her flat from water and cold. This is the only work made by a foreign artist. His name is Igor Klon. He lives in Israel, Tel Aviv, and he made this work not on a 19th century building, of course. It is a Soviet building, but it is the first brick house in a former village, which appeared after the Soviet time, in Soviet times, to be a part of Nizhny Novgorod. So the former village had a free stored building that was then reconstructed, and the fourth level was constructed in a few years then. Still, there are some active people who are trying to defend their house because nobody knows what can happen to even Soviet time old houses. As I guess lots of you know, that there is a project right now that is emerging in Moscow, dedicated especially to Soviet times fifth floor houses that are going to be demolished, and people are very aware of this situation and trying to defend their right to live in the property that they own. This is a project by Krasnodar-based art group ZIP. It is impossible to speak about good projects and good cases without naming this amazing art group. So they joined our festival in 2016, and they thought about portraying the values of a brick historical houses and the values of the residents who live there. After research, they found that some people from the house are not in contact, and some people even don't know each other. they discovered that back in time, previous generation of people were making a weekend tea parties in the yard and gathered the current inhabitants to a Saturday tea party. They painted the leaflets, made a bulletin board, constructed a special red table, and really managed to gather people and acquaint them with each other. So, first of all, when we thought about this project, we had an idea that it could be a total failure. But at the end of this Saturday tea party, real people from this house just met each other, said, "Ah, I see, I saw your dog, I saw your cat. Oh, sorry, I saw your bike, it was parked near my window. Please don't do this anyway, in any time further." So it is very, it was really funny because those people have common goals and common problems that are worth solving, but because of lack of contact, it was impossible to do so. In 2016, another artist from Yekaterinburg, Udmurt, made a work on historical building during the festival. The problem of an active resident from this house was that no one knew about the building being an accommodation unit. Everyone knew about a cafe, a yoga space, a dance place, or something like that. Even there was a moment when the building was set on fire and the fire brigade had no information about people living there. So it was a very close moment, a very difficult situation, because when the fire brigade saw people opening this door and just asking, "What is happening? Sorry," they were just shouting, calling someone's names, because it was a risk of death. In order to state clearly that there are people who live in this house, the artist painted the door pure white, hanged a post box that was previously absent, and an address tablet with a correct number. So you can see the post box and the correct number, so that people can understand that it is a living place and it is someone is trying to make it better. This is another work that was made in 2016. Actually, it is not a 19th century building too. It is an early building built for workers of a manufactory in Soviet time. And of course, it was a building that was built for a couple of years, for about a decade. And everyone thought that we will live there, we will work, and then we will go to another building. Of course, it has never happened. It is a common thing for many projects that were presented today and yesterday. We connected with people who live there and who, even knowing all the problems of living in this house, don't even know how they can live, moving to another block of flats with a lift, with good conditions, but really far from the garden, from the forest, and so on. So Nizhny Novgorod artist Anton Morkov thought about painting two murals. Actually, this is the first part of the mural, which is called The Forest. So he tried to illustrate the time that the forest is decaying and then appearing in another mural. During the festival, we always organize excursions to show a wide public, to show for a wide public of Nizhny Novgorod people some street art projects. Usually, we are showing not only the works in the historical center of the city, but trying to involve people in local history and architecture. Regularly, there are about 50 to 60 people attending and participating in these excursions, but sometimes it's about up to 100 people. It is a huge crowd. It is impossible even to walk with them. So right now, all our excursions we are making with portable sound speakers because of a huge interest of people who live in Nizhny Novgorod. Last year, we opened an exhibition which is called Alike. In Russian, it is called Налицо. In the local gallery Futuro. It was a central event of the festival dedicated to find a parallel between handcrafted wooden architecture elements, window casing moldings. In Russian, it is called nalichniki, and street artists. The very subjective theory was a key to think about elements of decorative art in street art, and grab the attention to extincting architecture. During the exhibition, we made a parallel program with workshops, lectures, and excursions. So right now, we are planning another project for this year, which is called Back Home. It is an exhibition in a historical building that was built in 1842, which was first a museum of one of the first Nizhny Novgorod revolutionists, sisters Nevzorovy, in which house Lenin stayed a couple of times. But later in the building in 1993, the building became a museum of Nizhny Novgorod intelligentsia, and actually it is the only Russian city where there was any kind of Russian intelligentsia museum. It was not a prior ideological twist from the Revolutionaries Museum to Nizhny Novgorod Intelligentsia Museum, but it was a chance to defend the house from it and its surroundings from further development. Right now, the house is empty, and the museum left it 5 years ago. There are activists who are trying to popularize the history of this place and defend it from further destruction. And we are going to make a temporary exhibition in September, taking it for rent from a regional administration. It is this project is some kind of idea to test some of our successes and accomplishments that we did in past 2 years. Because of course you are making art projects and you can't expect that people are going to get some real value. For example, their home will be safe, or developer will think, oh, you've made an art piece on this wall. We will never think about deconstructing it anyway. The main accomplishment of our festival and all the work that we do legally or illegally is making huge interest in this cultural heritage, and especially in modern local history. And I guess right now the notion of Nizhny Novgorod street art is a part of city's identity, and trying to work on behalf the future of Nizhny Novgorod, because in 2018 we are going to host FIFA World Cup, and the cultural heritage and historical wooden buildings are a big problem for the administration, and of course they are thinking about how to cover them with banners or something like that, or demolish and make parkings, benches with Wi-Fi or something like that. Yes, thank you. And